There's promising news regarding the vaccine against HPV. A new study shows the vaccination program against HPV is helping reduce infections in precancerous cervical lesions. Canadian researchers say in the last 10 years, infections dropped 83% among girls 13 to 19 and 66% among women 20 to 24.
Well, HPV is the most common STD in the country, and the CDC has some new guidelines about that virus.
News 19's Rosemarie Belts is here to explain. Rose.
Thanks, Alicia. And again, that most common STD is the human papillomavirus, better known as the HPV virus. So there are more than 40 different types of HPV in two categories, low and high risk strains. Most types of HPV go away before causing serious health problems, but some strains of the virus can cause genital warts and cancers like anal, cervical, vaginal, and even mouth and throat cancers. Most often, HPV is spread through sexual contact by partners who do not have visible symptoms. And in fact, a person can have HPV for months or even years and not know it. The best way to protect against HPV is abstinence from sex, being in a mutually monogamous relationship with an uninfected partner, and get the HPV vaccine. This week, CDC's Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices voted unanimously, let me say that again, to recommend HPV vaccines for boys, girls, men, and women through age 26. And now it suggests adults ages 27 to 45 who haven't been vaccinated to talk with their doctors about it. So to be clear, there's no treatment for the virus itself. However, you can talk to your medical provider about treatments for the health problems that the HPV vaccine or HPV virus can cause. I'm Rosemarie Belton, back to you guys.